Yo, what's up, guys? It's the Sneaky Beagle, and welcome back to SOT Talks. In today's SOT Talk, we're going to be covering 10 settings that I feel every player on Sea of Thieves should be aware of. To be honest, a lot of these are common sense, but what I find is common sense is not always common practice. I know there's a lot of you out there that don't have these changed, okay? Don't lie. I said don't lie. All right, guys, starting at number 10, we're going to talk about toggling your HUD. This is not mission critical, but what you're going to do is scroll all the way down and set up a keybind for toggling your HUD. The HUD is your in-game overlay. So if you lose health, it'll be on the bottom left corner. If you have ammo and you've used some of it, that will show up in the bottom right. Things like in-game pop-ups, information, that will all be under the HUD. If you disable this, all of your crew names will disappear. This is for you want to be able to capture clean screenshots with your buddies or whatever. This is a setting that is kind of nice to have just toggleable instead of having a screenshot that has in-game information on it. The next setting we're going to go to is gameplay, and you're going to go to Island Banners in Adventure. This is number 9. I changed this to Slimline. It's set to cinematic by default. It's very intrusive on the screen versus Slimline just looks very nice. In Arena, I have that turned off. All right, guys, coming in at number 8 is under keyboard and mouse. This is at the absolute very bottom, directly below the setting we changed in number 10. This is mute all other crew's voice chat with a single button. If you run into a toxic crew that's spouting off obscenities at you, you can press one button and it will mute everything. All right, guys, setting number 7 here is under audio settings. All the way at the bottom of audio settings, you're going to go to push to talk, and you want to change this to hold because by default, you are hot miking in the game. If you change this to hold, you can select a keybind under keyboard and mouse, but you definitely want to set a keybind for this and put this on hold so that you're not just hot miking in game. Bonus tip, turn on player chat indicator. This will put a little word bubble in the top right corner of your screen when you're talking, so you know if you're hot miking in game. All right, guys, so for step 6, we are going under accessibility. You're going about a quarter of the way down, and what you want to really make sure you do is turn on your translate other players option. It is really nice to run into another crew that's speaking another language and be able to see what they're saying. It can give you strategy information you wouldn't have otherwise. You don't want to miss that translation. Also, bonus settings that I'll give you, turn on text-to-speech override so that you can see it even if you don't hear it, and turn on speech-to-text override. All right, guys, for step 5, what you want to be doing is going to your graphics settings, and you want to enable your water detail. Now, this is preference, okay? Sometimes you're going to want to move this down to cursed. If you're fighting a bored, happy boat, it can be easier to see players in the water when it's on cursed settings, or you might be fishing for Legendary Hunter of the Sea of Thieves. It is easier to see what type of fish is on your line when you're on cursed water settings. Every once in a while, it can be helpful to know that water can be changed to give you a visual advantage. All right, guys, so for setting number 4, we're going to go back to accessibility, and we are going to be changing high contrast X marks the spot. By default, this is off. I personally find it's helpful because instead of a red X on a map that also has red elements on it, you get a nice bright white X. I find it insanely helpful, especially on those ancient vaults that sometimes you get little corners of a map. If you see a little white dot in the middle of a bunch of green, it can be incredibly helpful in those situations. All right, guys, so for setting number 3, mouse sensitivity. I find this incredibly important. My mouse is set to 800 DPI. It never changes. And my in-game sensitivity is 1.2. The setting I really want to talk about, though, is increasing your blunderbuss, flintlock, eye of reach, and trident aim to 10. When you're aiming down your sights, this is the speed at which it moves. You want it to be able to free move when you're aiming down sights so it doesn't feel like you're underwater. Generally, if you have a lower sensitivity and a lower mouse sensitivity in-game and a lower DPI, you're going to have more control over your shots. The important thing again here are these settings down here. Coming in at number two, we are going back down to accessibility. And what you want to look for here is reduce hold to interact. You want to turn this on. This makes it so that it's a one button press to interact with a reloading of a cannon. It's a one button press to pick up that chest in front of you. It also helps you drop anchors on enemy boats easier. Other really useful situation this helps, when you have to res a teammate, you can still get that incredible movement like I talked about in the last video, enosing. You can actually enos while you res a teammate. All right, guys, last and most important setting. This is the most important moment of your entire life. 78 is not an ideal field of view. Bump this up to 90. Do yourself a favor. It's going to allow you to see enemy players better. It's going to be able to give you more field of view while you're sailing. The only time that you want to mess with this is if you're taking in-game screenshots. 60 field of view is very cinematic. Otherwise, leave this at 90, guys. You'll thank me you did. You're going to improve at the game just because of this setting. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. I'll see you in the next SOT Talk. Hey, guys, thanks for attending today's SOT Talk. I really appreciate you being here. If you found the video helpful in any way, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Like, comment, subscribe. It really helps the channel. I appreciate you. And if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, feel free to also stop by my live stream. I stream on Twitch most weeknights at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And as always, guys, stay sneaky, my friends. Stare at the camera awkwardly as you forget the rest of the